The black hoodie is back, baby, and you know what it means. It means it's time for some game devs revenge. I've been watching a lot of Countdown lately, especially the 8 out of 10 cats version. And while I do okay at the numbers game, you may have noticed I have this speech impediment called being French, which makes me bad at the letters game, so I need to write some code that will make me the very best, like no one ever was. For those who are under 60, here's a recap of the letters game of Countdown. It's actually quite simple. 9 letters are drawn in a pseudo-random manner. There's a bunch of vowels and a bunch of consonants. The contestants then have 30 seconds to find the longest word they can using those letters, and the contestant who comes up with the longest word wins. A 9-letter word, thus guaranteeing an instant win. From an algorithmic standpoint, there is no optimal way to come up with a solution other than brute force, trying out every possible letter combination, and this takes a lot of time, even for a computer. A better approach, albeit quite a naive one, would be to read through every word of the dictionary and check whether this word is composed of the set of letters that are available to us. So let's start by doing just that. I downloaded a big list of every word in the English language, and after removing words that wouldn't work in Countdown, such as hyphenated words, the final list has more than 400,000 words and weighs 4 megabytes. With this prep work out of the way, I can start working on a function that goes through the list of words and for each word checks whether it can be built from the provided set of random letters. If it can, we keep track of it if it is the longest word so far, and then we move on to the next word. This works okay, but as you can imagine, it is quite slow, about 250 milliseconds. We can add a few tricks to optimize this a bit. First off, when we find a 9-letter word, we can stop right away as we know we won't find a better word. Second, let's feed it a list of words that have been sorted beforehand. This way, as soon as the function finds a word, we can break the loop as this has to be the longest word available. Finally, we'll filter the list to only keep words that are at least 6 letters long. No need to waste compute time on words that I could find myself without too much trouble. All this does yield better results, but barely a 5% improvement. What we need is a killer solution, a perfect way to get the best word instantly. And what a surprise, this is actually a great opportunity to talk about what may be my favorite data structure, the try. Wow. But what does it do? Well, a try is a type of tree that excels at storing strings, like really. In a try, each node represents a single character of a string. For instance, let's add the word cat to an empty try. We need to add the C node, which gives an A child, which in turn has a T child. Now let's add cats. C is already there, so are A and T, so we just have to add a trailing S. Now let's add cattle. C, A, T. And here we need to branch out and add another T node before adding L and E. When adding new words, we simply follow along the tree, adding new nodes when needed. And then we just need some sort of flag to tell which nodes are actually words. This is obvious for nodes that have no children, but there might be words that end up somewhere up in the chain, especially singular forms. The recursive nature of the try makes it very simple to implement. Regarding the node class, we need a value for the node, a flag for the end of a word, and a map of children nodes. That's it. During the building phase, when you try to get a node, if it exists, it is returned. If not, it is created. Finally, we need a try class that has a simple empty node that serves as root. Adding to the try is simple, we just iterate over the string of characters, getting the next node in the try each time, relying on the fact that it will be implicitly created if it doesn't exist. Then once we reach the final letter node, we mark it as a leaf. Looking up the list of words that match a series of characters is slightly more complicated because there's some recursion, but it's really manageable. We start with the current node, initially this is the root node, an array of the string of characters we have traversed so far, initially it is empty, and an array of the characters from our countdown series. For each of the remaining characters of our series, we check to see if it makes a valid path we can go down and recursively call our lookup function. If we reach a leaf node, we add the current string of characters to the list of results. And here's the beauty of the try, right? You don't make unnecessary computation, you will only go down a branch of the tree if you're on track to find a valid word down the line. There's no pruning, no dead end, it's just perfection. Let's try it out, adding a few words. This is what the graph of the try looks like, and now we can try looking upwards. Looks great so far. Now let's load the big fat list of words. Let's take a moment to consider the sheer number of words there are to search. Here's the graph of the final try. Look at the size of the scroll bar. And then realize that actually, I lied to you. This is the graph of only the words that start with the letter A. And here's where the only downside of the try shows. There is some initialization time. Building the try takes about a second, which is already more than the first search strategy. However, once initialized, I can search for words multiple times without having to rebuild the try. Looking up all the words in a series runs amazingly fast though, at an average of 2.2 milliseconds for a search. That's literally 100 times faster than the first approach we tried. And I know what you're gonna say, but Leonard, if the naive approach is only 250 milliseconds and the timer runs for 30 whole seconds, you don't need the faster approach and are therefore engaging in premature optimization. To which I say, do you really think they're going to let me bring my full-size desktop computer onto the set? I need something stealthy that I can conceal on my person, like a Raspberry Pi for instance. And these have a CPU that is quite not the same as the one in my desktop computer. I converted the original C# code to JavaScript to run it on my Raspberry Pi B Plus that I have lying around. And the naive approach runs in 15 seconds, which is already a lot closer to the 30-second limit. And would certainly have failed if I had an older version of the Pi or a smaller device. The try, on the other hand, runs in 200 milliseconds on average, which is great. It does take a full minute to build though, which is a long time, but I can have it run before entering the studio and then it's no problem. The next question we have is how am I going to input the letters into the program if everything is supposed to be concealed? I think the easiest way to do this is via Morse code, as I basically only need three wires to make it work. What I'm imagining is having conductive metal rings, which I am currently fashioning out of aluminum foil, but picture them as actual rings. I can have a logic up ring that touches either a dash ring or a dot ring, sending a logic up signal to the program. When the rings aren't touching, the signal is pulled down by a resistor. Finally, the result is sent to a small LCD display. Sending input in Morse code takes a little practice, and also does take some time, so I'm sure glad the word search takes under a second to complete. Thanks to my device, I am now the best countdown player in the world. I am unstoppable. If you made it this far, thank you very much for watching. You can subscribe if you want to see more videos like this, and if you want even more, you can support the channel on Patreon to get bonus video content and the source code for every project. This time, the bonus video is going to be about, surprise surprise, solving the numbers game of countdown. I guess I'll see you in the next video. Until then, have a good one.